Hello everyone, I'm Dustin Phelps with FormAssembly, and today I want to show you how bad web design is hurting your data collection. Now, all businesses, big or small, know that good data and good data collection is key to your business's success as it affects your sales funnel, marketing strategies, and more. But what you might not realize is how your website's bad design might be hurting your data collection. Now, there are many different ways you can collect and analyze data, such as monitoring click-through rates, form submissions, and tracking. But today, we're going to be focusing on collecting data through web form submissions by funneling visitors to your web forms. So first, before we get into the design, we need to talk about bounce rate. If your site isn't what a visitor expected to find, or they do not find what they are looking for, they will bounce, meaning they will leave your site after viewing one page. This can happen if your site isn't properly listed or has a misleading description. Now, a high bounce rate could indicate that they found what they wanted pretty fast and left, but this is unlikely if they're leaving without clicking elsewhere on your site. This is important to consider as we move forward because high bounce rates can negatively affect your ranking in search results. So in order to get your visitors to turn to leads, conversions, and sales, you need to be able to keep them on your site. On average, you have about 15 seconds or less to capture a website visitor's attention and get them to start interacting with your site. If you haven't done so by then, you've probably lost them. That's a potential big lead slipping through the cracks. But how do you keep them there? Well, first, let's talk about attraction. Humans are pretty judgmental creatures, but that's not always a bad thing. It helps us make quick decisions that can often have big consequences. We're used to trusting our eyes to tell us the information we need in order to survive, form relationships, and even purchase a product. When we visit a site, it's with only a few seconds that we form our opinion about the company and their product. Research has shown that we form our first impression within 7 seconds, and some studies suggest this happens even within a second. This is why good solid branding is so important. I'm not going to go into detail in this video about how to create visual branding for your company, but what you do need to know is that first impressions matter. Your site should be pleasing to the eye and appropriate for your audience, using colors, layouts, and imagery that instantly connect with your visitors. This also means your design should be up to date. If your site looks old or outdated, your visitors might get the impression that your company isn't keeping up with the times and might opt for that competitor of yours that is more relatable. Good branding creates trust and credibility. Again, you only have a few seconds to grab your visitors' attention, so your verbiage and imagery should hook them in. This can be done with a bold header or a striking image that relates to your target audience. Using people in your designs is also helpful, as we're naturally inclined to connect with human faces. Your header text should be short and to the point, yet make them want to know more. Clarity, besides branding, might be the most important aspect of web design. If you can't communicate clearly, you won't sell or get leads. Someone who has no idea who you are should be able to understand exactly what you do and what the value is for them after visiting your website for the first time. Guide your visitors to where you want them to go. You know where your contact form, demo form, or signup page is, but they don't. As Steve Krug says in the popular web design book, Don't Make Me Think, don't make me think. The path you want your visitors to follow should be clear and easy to follow, with as little effort from the visitor as possible on how to get there. You can do this by using clear CTA buttons, simple text, and images that help guide the visitor through the funnel, as well as limiting the number of clicks it takes to get to the end goal. This means you should be placing the most valuable action items above the fold. The fold in web design refers to the bottom of the viewable window. Essentially, anything that a viewer can see without scrolling is above the fold. This is the space where all first impressions are going to happen, and many website visitors don't make it very far below the fold before clicking a button or leaving. Additionally, you want to limit the options for your visitors. Use your brand colors to create buttons that contrast against the rest of the information. You should only have a few of these, and they should be your most important CTAs. Ideally, you would only have one CTA button, because this tends to command the most attention, but at least try to keep it to less than 3. You want to keep this number low because trying to make every button or link on your page stand out will result in nothing standing out. Besides, the goal here is to guide your visitors to make a purchase or fill out a form, not confuse them. The last item involving clarity I want to mention is avoiding clutter. I know I just said you need the most important info above the fold, but that doesn't mean all of your info should be above the fold. Allow your content to breathe, which in turn allows the areas of focus to actually become an area that can be focused on. Let's be honest, we live in a TLDR world. While you don't want to throw a ton of text and information at a visitor that they will never read, you still want to be informative. This can mean crafting your text in a way that gets straight to the point and avoids too much fluff, or providing a way for the visitors to learn more if they want to dive deeper. Lastly, provide something of value. We can't expect website visitors to give us their information for nothing in return. The item of value should also be proportionate to the amount of information you're asking for. For example, you could offer visitors an interactive checklist, instructional guide, or planning template in exchange for their contact information. Now, all of these practices are great, but if your site visitors get to the web form and it doesn't follow the same principles we just went through, then you're going to have a hard time getting them to fill out the form, which was kind of the whole point. Thankfully, FormAssembly makes it easy to create secure, user-friendly web forms that can be customized to fit your website and your company's brand. We have a few other videos on our channel you can check out that go into more detail about web form best practices and web form design. To learn more about how FormAssembly can help improve your data collection, visit our website by clicking the link in the description below. So there are a few ways that improving your web design can help you collect data and convert prospects. I hope you found the information in this video helpful. If you want to learn more about data collection best practices, as well as other tips and tricks, subscribe to our channel and be sure to hit the notification bell icon to receive alerts when we release a new video. Thanks for watching, and as always, happy form building.